Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel KTM Booster. Today we will be having simple interest topic part 3. In previous two parts we have discussed the simple problems and definitions and the formulas of simple interest. Now some advanced level of the simple interest we will going to discuss in this today's session. So starting with first question, after how many years we have to calculate the T, right? Will a sum of rupees, a sum of rupees means principal, that is 12,500 rupees becomes 17,500, means what? This will be amount. 17,500 is what? Amount. At the rate of 10% per annum, means R is given, that is 10, right? So P is given, A is given. So what is SI? SI is what? Amount minus principal. I have given in part 1 and part 2, right? So 17,500 minus 12,500, so our SI will be 5,000. This will be our SI, right? So we know the formula for SI, that is P into R into T divided by 100. What is SI? That is 5,000. Okay, now what is P? P is given, that is 12,500. What is R? That is 10. And T we have to calculate, divided by 100. This 20 will be cancelled. This 10 will be cancelled over here, right? So we left with 500, that is T is equal to 500 divided by 125. Now we cancel this by using 25 5s are 25 2s are 0 5 1s are 5 4s are. That will be 4 years. Now you see the second question. This is very interesting question. They have asked the difference of ESI, right? So the principal is given, that is 500. The principal is same for both the cases, that is 500 rupees. So we will see the case first, right? And for case second, right? In both cases we have to calculate SI. For case first, we have to calculate the SI for R equal to 5 and time period equal to 3 years. And for case second, we have given 4% as rate and time is 4 years. Okay, so SI is equal to P into R into T upon 100. So what is P? P is same, that is 500. What is R? That is 5. What is T? That is 3, divided by 100. So 00 will get cancelled. 5 5s are 25, 3s are 75 rupees. Okay, now here what is SI? That is PRT upon 100. So what is P? That is same, that is 500 multiplied by rate is 4 and time period is again 4 years, divided by 100. This 20 will be cancelled. 4 4s are 16 16 5s are 80. So here 80 rupees. So the difference will be, so the difference in SI, that is 80 minus 75, that is 5 rupees. This will be the answer. Now we will see question number 3, that is what is the simple interest on a sum of rupees 7700. So sum is given, that is principal, that is 700 rupees. This will be the principal. If the rate of interest for the first 3 years is T is 3, what is the rate of interest? That is 8. Okay, first 3 years is 8% and for the last 2 years is 7%. For the last 2 years the rate is what? The 7%. We have to calculate the simple interest for 3 years and for 2 years. Okay, so we will calculate by using the formula, that is SI is equal to PRT upon 100. What is P? 700 into R is 8 into T is 3 divided by 100. So 7 into 24. Okay, we have to calculate by using this. Okay, now we'll multiply this, that is 7 4s are 28 to 7 2s are 14 plus 2, that is 16 rupees, 168 rupees. Now for 2 years, what is SI? P is 700, multiplied by r is 7 and t is what, 2 divided by 100. Okay, these two will be cancelled. That is 7 7s are 49 into 2, that is 98 rupees, isn't it? Now the sum, right, the simple interest. Okay, so for first case this will be 168, and for second case the simple interest will be 98. So 8 plus 8 16, 1 6 plus 1, that is 2, that is 266 rupees. This will be the simple interest for first 3 years and for last 2 years. Now we'll see the question number 4, that is, what is the rate of simple interest for the first 4 years if the sum of rupees 360 becomes 540. Now our principal is what, 360 rupees, and the amount, what is amount, that is 540. This will be the amount now in 9 years. So for first 4 years the rate of interest is different, and for last 5 years the rate of interest is different, that is 6%, right? So SI is equal to A minus P, that is A is 540 and P is what, 360, right? So 540 minus 360, that is 180 rupees. Okay, now we have to take the two simple interest for this 180 rupees total simple interest. Okay, so we will take here plus and here equal to, simple interest equal to 180 rupees. So for first 5 years and for last 4 years we have to concentrate, right? For the first 4 years, right, so P is what, 360 into R we have to calculate for the first 4 years, and for the last 5 years P into R, R is 6 multiplied by what, T. This will be the equation for our question. Okay, so this 0, this 0, this 0 will be cancelled, right? So we can take common as 36 divided by 100, right? So in bracket we can write 4R plus what, 30, okay, equal to what, 180, isn't it? Now we can write, that is 4R plus 30 is equal to 180 into 100 divided by 36. 18 ones are, 18 zeros are, 18 twos are, 18, okay, 18 twos are, simply. Okay, now here 2 ones are, 2 fives are, okay, so here 500. Okay, so now we will calculate this, that is 4R equal to 500 minus 30, that is 470. So R equal to 470 divided by 4. Okay, now here we are having this 470, wait a minute, 4R upon 30. Okay, we have taken common 36 upon 10. So here 36 upon 10 will be there, no zero, right? So 180 multiplied by 10, right, and 5 into 10, that is 50. Okay, so 4R equal to what, yes, 4R equal to 50 minus 30, that is 20, and R equal to, so 20 divided by 4, that is R equal to 5%. This is my mistake, I have taken 100, this is 10 that we have taken at outside. Okay, so this will be the answer for this question. For more such type of videos, please subscribe our YouTube channel. Thank you.